Good morning to all of you. At the outset, let me thank Dr. Bhatia for having invited me here this morning to share my thoughts with all of you and also giving me an opportunity to learn from each one of you sitting in this hall. I have huge respect for Dr. Bhatia for the passion which he has, the commitment which he has for the cause, the people touch which he has, and he brings the HR fraternity always together for so many times in a year. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a huge round of applause to Dr. Bhatia for making human resource proud of what we are today. Thank you, sir, for your endeavor. I will touch upon, it's always very difficult to speak our stalwarts, like Indra Parekh has spoken here, taken away a few of the thoughts which I had already in my slides, so I might skip it or I'll try to change the story which I already had in mind. Now, innovation in HR, I have put up a story where what is happening in the environment first, and then come to what is happening in the HR, so that we are able to link with business and environment and see what is for all of us on the table. I think the biggest challenge which we all are facing is the pace of change. The world has changed, the world has evolved. If I look at industrialization, it's about 400 years old, but I think last 100 years has been very, very disruptive. And out of last 100 years, I think last 20 years has been extremely disruptive. Ever since the computer came into the work environment, we have seen how the transition has changed. Ma'am talk about artificial intelligence, which is the next curve, and I am sure we will see far more disruption as we go forward. But change is there as a constant, as we know, but I think the only challenge today is the pace of change. When I started my career, we used to have all this technology up on board, and some of you would be able to relate with this. Today, none of this exists, and I think we have moved to all laptops and desktop kind of a thing. Knowledge earlier, once acquired, we say this is take us for next 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. I think the rate of obsolescence of knowledge is very high, and which is also resulting into very high rate of talent obsolescence. Something again in the I talked about. How do you develop your talent so that they are relevant today and they are prepared for the future? So the talent obsolescence rate with technology coming at a very, very fast speed, I think is a huge challenge for all of us. Because believe me one thing, organization A is superior to organization B only because of the sets of talent pool the organization A has over organization B, because anybody who has money into the pocket can set up organization as good as the organization we all come and work for. So I think the quality of talent pool actually decides how a company A is superior or inferior to the next company. Innovation, I think, is something which is not a choice for any one of us, be it in HR, be it in the processes, because if you don't innovate, the others are innovating and they will take on us. So I think innovation is something today organizations are writing in mandatory into the performance appraisal, that what is that new thing you have done in the organization? What is the continuous improvement you have brought in the organization for which you should be rewarded and rewarded substantially? Because the repetitive nature of job doesn't take us anywhere. I get to see two kinds of manager when I interview people and when I meet people. One are people with 10 years of experience, and the other actually 1 year of experience repeated for 10 years. So I think we need to understand which category of employee we belong. Is our experience repetitive in nature? If so, then the obsolescence is very, very fast, and I think we need to understand that. I think today the competition has gone global. No way to be India best. I think we have to be the world best. I think that is where the market is defining. So the talent pool should also be able to cater to the competition, which is globally competitive, and as an organization, we should be able to compete and survive. Today, world-class practices, I think, is something every organization is adopting, and organizations of today can survive only if they are adopting to the world-class best practices. And I think a classical example I can give you from one automotive industry, if you look at Maruti Suzuki today in India, they are not even top 10 globally, but in India they are sitting with 50% market share. And if you look at the companies which are globally number 1, 2, 3, in India they are struggling for 1% to 6% market share. There is something this company is doing differently. And latest 2 days back in Economics Times, it says that they are the richest automobile company today globally. So I think organizations need to redefine and bring world-class practices. I think while the world is changing very fast, I think this is the point I think we need to understand, and understand from the HR perspective, more importantly, that we are living in the world of sameness. You know, while the change is happening very fast, if you ask me, there is fundamentally no difference between Coke and Pepsi and Nike and Adidas, because basically you are buying a brand. In terms of quality, they assure you the quality whatever they are serving, or whether you buy a Toyota car or a Honda car. So the issue is, if somebody is bringing a unique USP into their product, the competition has to compete it in the 2 months' time or 3 months' time to be there, because customer is looking for sameness in terms of products and services. So I think we need to understand that we are living in the world of sameness. So catching up time in terms of capability, catching up time in terms of product, catching up time in terms of service, catching up time, the way we do business differently, I think has shrunk and shrunk dramatically. I think traditionally, if you look at it, the competitiveness used to be some of these factors. I am not saying that these factors are not relevant today: cost, technology, distribution, manufacturing, product feature, core competence. These are important today for being traditionally competitive. But I think what has taken stage beyond tangibles are the intangible, which are mostly people driven. The speed which we address grievances, the responsiveness which we have, the customer intimacy which we kind of demonstrate, the agility we bring in the organization, the employees' capability development which we bring in, and leadership and business strategy. So the point which I'm trying to drive home is the new age economy is more about intangible, which are typically driven by people. And this is where I think the human resource have an advantage over the artificial intelligence, which I will talk about later, because end of the day, the human touch will remain.